getting ready to put a track bar on here, and what I need to do is I need to get some measurements.
I'm going to go by the shock tower and the edge of the tire, which is going to be, I want it to be kind of in the center of the shock tower. Looks like it is going to be 3.5 on this side.
I got to do the same on the other side. The other side is also 3.5. So that tells me where I've got to be at when I get this track bar installed. How far the tires need to be from the shock tower, which is attached to the frame, even though the springs are attached to the axle. So I went from the shock tower, not the actual spring. So I believe this is the factory track bar that's in this. You've got a single bolt right there. There's a single bolt down here. So I'm putting an adjustable Rough Country track bar in. And let's get started. There's all kinds of play in that. And I got this one here to take out. And then I need to see if that's the same bracket that I just ordered. I think, kind of think that it is. So the driver's side was a 21 bolt and nut. And the passenger side is a 22 bolt. Well, actually the bolt is a 22 and the nut I think is a 21. Now you can probably see that I was using a cheater bar on the other side. I'm gonna use the same on this side too. Looks like the nut. And it's not going to pull out, so we'll just have to keep ratcheting it out. See if we can bring it out with this a little quicker. Easy peasy, just the way I like it. Wow, I just realized you probably wasn't able to see any of that. Oh well, sorry. So the end that attached to the other side was pretty, you can kind of see there. Like this is just, you could just tell that rubber grommet in there is just shot. All kinds of play in it. This end down here, the other end is pretty stiff, still in pretty good shape. I'm pretty certain this is the factory one because it's not adjustable. So the one that I got's adjustable. It's a Rough Country 1179. Wow, this is way beefier than the one I took out of it. You can definitely see the difference in the size. Just the visual inspection of it's better. No play in that one whatsoever. So what I got to do is I got to get these the same length. Since both wheels were already set up correctly, they were 3.5 from the shock tower to the wheel on both sides. I don't need to adjust anything. That means the one that was in it was the right length. So I'll show you a trick on getting these adjusted. You're going to need the bolts from each side. So the one that had the 22-inch head, this one is the one that was on the driver's side. And then this one that didn't have, doesn't have the washer built onto it, was on the passenger side. This one was 22 millimeter, this one was 21 millimeter, this one was 22 millimeter. Either way, what we're gonna do, we're gonna take and put the old one through here. Then we're gonna lay the new one right on top of it, just like that. And then we're gonna come to the other end and kind of see the difference there. We're going to adjust the adjustable one until it fits. Right down on there, like it was made for it. And I'm probably gonna have to go find a pipe wrench or something. So it's getting pretty hard to turn. Probably a pipe wrench, vice grips, channel locks, any of those would work to turn that sleeve down. I grabbed the first thing I found that I thought would work. And I'm just going to use it, which is vice grips. I'm not going to put them on there too tight, but tight enough where I can turn it, hopefully. Probably going to be about 7,000 people comment how I'm doing this wrong, scratching the paint. Hey, these are my parts. I'll put them on however the hell I feel like it. Uh-oh, about one more turn, maybe. Look at that. Perfect. So as you can see, we got the bolt through there, the bolt through there, but we'll know when we measure it. So this right here sets our initial size. I might put the sleeves on it now. I might wait. I think I will wait. But let's get it in there. Might maybe go ahead and put this thing I'm gonna put this bolt in this other end just to hold it in place. Because this one down here is gonna have to be kind of knew when I took the old one out that it was in there really tight. You get a hammer. Oh, I see it moving down. Yay. Oops, sorry about that. Let me show you what I'm working with here. See the hole there not lined up. I might be able to just stick a screwdriver in there and get it to go over some. I don't want to have to adjust the bar, because I think the bar is correct. I think the body just slid. I got a screwdriver right here. I don't know. Oh, I think that worked. I'll probably never do that twice ever. I mean, it's moved some. It's not quite all the way there yet, but it's pretty close. I'll tell you, don't get no better than that. Oh, there's a washer goes on there. Sometimes you just get lucky. Just like that. Yeah, that screwdriver trick worked. Yeah, so now what I'll do, I'll tighten down the two M bolts and I'll check my shock tower to wheel clearance. And if they're the same, I'll lock it down with the adjustment there. You're going to cheat a little bit. Do the final torque manually. Let's see, this one was a 21, not the 22. This might be a little more difficult to do the nut, because that'd be all right.
Okay.
So now we're back to checking this, and if we're still at 3.5 inches, we are in good shape. If it's not at 3.5 inches, we're in trouble. Well, not really, we just got to adjust it.
And I've got 3 3/8.
So let me check the other side. Yep, I need to adjust it over, and so give us another 1/8 of an inch in this direction. So let me do that. Let's see, to push that over. Oh, I've got to shorten it.
Oh my gosh, I got it on the first try.
Probably never do that again. So basically all I was doing was turning this adjuster. I gave it like not even a full turn. It was maybe 3, so I could only get like a quarter of a turn. So I did like 3/4 of a turn, and that was right. So now it's just getting those on there and tightened up. Then I'll take it for a test drive and come back and check it again to make sure that everything's still in alignment. So these bolts are supposed to be set to 125 foot-pounds on these end bolts here. And then they don't give a spec for the other ones. So